Stanford University.
We're looking along this coast and we're saying, where do we have fresh water moving out to sea? Where do we have salt water moving on to land?
We're using a geophysical method called electrical resistivity tomography to image the aquifers under the ground and look at the contact between fresh water and salt water.
Once you have models of where this saltwater-freshwater interface is, then you can start predicting how the saltwater-freshwater interface will move. Information about where the saltwater-freshwater interface is essential for thinking about proactive groundwater management along this coast. They're covering about 2.5 to 3 kilometers a day. They lay out cables, and these cables are attached to stakes in the ground, 22.5 meters apart, that are used to send current into the ground and to make potential measurements.
What that can show you is the resistivity of the subsurface. So if you have fresh water, it's going to be much more resistive to passing current than if you have salt water. And because of that contrast between the two, we're able to see where there's salt water and where there's fresh water. If you have salt water intrusion, it means where you once had fresh water, you now have salt water, which you can't use to drink, you can't use it to irrigate your fields.
Two things can cause saltwater intrusion along this coast. One is if we pump extensively from the groundwater aquifers, that reduces the amount of fresh water on the landward side, and so salt water can move in. The other thing that can happen is sea level rise. And as sea level rises, that increases the forcing of salt water onto land. In many places, we think of groundwater as our savings account. People tend to use surface water supplies, and then when there's a drought, they turn to groundwater, because groundwater is this large volume of water that's stored below the surface. This area, even before the drought, 99% of the fresh water used in Monterey County was coming from groundwater. The drought just makes the situation worse. You have people in the local water districts who are already thinking very creatively about what they can do moving forward to reduce the dependence on groundwater. Ideas about water conservation, ideas about desalination, ideas about freshwater recharge. So people in this community are very engaged in thinking about potential solutions to this problem.